Next topic number 2, facets of maintenance. Maintenance operations may have many facets, such as facets means some importance, some extra care, etc. So number 1 is emergency maintenance necessitated by unforeseen breakdown, drainage or damage caused by natural calamity like fire, floods, cyclone, earthquake, etc. Example, in Tamil Nadu government, we have a department named TWAD department, Tamil Nadu Water Supply and Drainage Board. In that, if there is any breakage in pipes which used to supply water, there is no need to take care of any contractor and getting contracts, quotes and all. So immediately we can call a contractor or a plumbing license holder to take care of the work, and then immediately the bill will get sanctioned. There is no need of any quotes and all. So that is the emergency maintenance. So this may be happen again at the time of fire, floods, cyclone, earthquakes, etc. Example, for the past 1 week, you may see in Assam, Kerala and Karnataka many floods. So the Prime Minister all announced some funding to the government for taking care of the floods work immediately, and for other departments also. So that will be under emergency maintenance. Number 2, condition based maintenance work initiated after due inspection. So some technical team should inspect the structure to which the maintenance to be carried out. The team which has visited should have some DPR, that means detailed project report, they should give one. With that DPR only the maintenance work will start, within after giving a NOC, no objection certificate, so that the work can be carried out. Next is fixed time maintenance activities repeated at predetermined intervals of time. So that intervals, we may know, for example, if a road is laying, they may take another 5 to 10 years, or maybe after 4 years also, depends on the highways, they may have overlay and then painting, etc. So that will be under fixed time maintenance. Next is facets of maintenance again. Preventive maintenance, this is intended to preserve by preventing failure and detecting incipient faults, such as work is done before failure takes place. Again, worm wound, compound, like that. So preventive maintenance, so that our structure will be always be looking fresh. Opportunity maintenance, work did as and when possible within the limits of operation demands. For example, in government department, JE has some funding limits. He can take care of the work without asking higher officials. So that can be used. And some other cases, the department itself allows some funding to maintain the structures. So that may be under opportunity maintenance. Day-to-day care and maintenance. For example, in our home, normally we used to clean the kitchen sinks and the toilets, sinks, except toilets and the water taps, pipes, etc. So that to be like day-to-day care and maintenance. Shutdown maintenance, you may heard this word in EB department. Normally they used to have 1 day in a month to have shutdown to cut the branches in the trees which is disturbing the EB wires, and any sort of activities to be carried out in the posts. So like that, if you're going to carry some work, you are just going to close the office, so that then only such work can be carried out. That type of maintenance system, the shutdown maintenance. Improvement plans, this is essentially maintenance operation wherein the weak links in the original construction are either replaced by new parts or strengthened. So you may be replaced, depends on the usage of the existing product and the structure, or you may be strengthened, that depends upon the needed. That is termed as improvement plan. And third one, importance of maintenance. It improves the lives of the structure. Yes, it will improve. So when we human beings have taken care of our human body to improve our life tenure, so immediately when we maintain the same for our structure, again our structure's life will also get improved. Improved life period gives better return on investment. Yes, I am sure that, because nowadays we are investing large amount in our structure, buildings, home. Say example, you may see in newspapers daily 75 lakhs, 80, 90, 1 crore, 1.25 lakhs, that's what the projects are going nowadays. So that investment we are putting over our building, then that life period should be have better term to have the returns of them. Then better appearance and aesthetically appealing. So if you maintain, again it will give the better appearance and aesthetic view. Better serviceability of elements of under components like painting or doing the patchwork, etc. Leads to quicker detection of defects and hence remedial measures. So whenever the problem, any defects arises, you should take care immediately, so that the defects can be arrested and the life of the structure will also get improved. Prevents major deterioration and leading to collapse. Again, if you do that only, then our the structure getting collapse can be prevented. Ensures safety to occupants. The occupants who are living inside the structure or building, they should feel that they are safe. At any time, they should not fear that our when our building will get collapsed, when our building get settled, etc. And ensures feeling of confidence on the user. So the user should feel some confidence.